All right, hold please while the Verizon customers. Okay, thank you. I will play some music, but the stuff in my phone yelling all night. It's all Beyonce. And she was here last night and the night before. I don't think anybody else wants to hear anymore.
Thank you.
You are welcome.
I mean, it's better, but it's a little.
Hey, good evening, everyone.
If you have a cell phone, be so kind as to put it on vibration, or so we don't want it to interrupt because we got some exciting things happening this evening, and I want to make sure that we give our award recipients all the love and happiness that we can give them. So we don't want any interruptions. So before I begin, let's give it back up for that warm introduction. You know, yes. Let me tell y'all something. We can't do that golf club little class. We got a really good club up in here. We are celebrating excellence. And we're so super excited to be celebrating excellence. I have had the honor and privilege of visiting with most of you, your tables, talking about your goals and your dreams here with Harvest Christian University. And before I go any further, can we see our president at? He Dr. Carl Robinson. He didn't know? Yes! Our executive vice president, the Bishop Dr. Michael Bates Sr. Yes, yes. Jerry Lewis in the house, yes? And Jonathan Robinson. I mean, we have it's just such an extraordinary team. As you all know, for those of you who are in business, you know it's something to pull the people together and create excellence like this. So one of the things that we're excited about is that we do have a philanthropy department where we're able to help people build, expand, get funding, and grow their business. Is there some people in here like that tonight? Yes, yes? I can't tell. You know, money is loud, and it like speed, and it moves real fast. Is there some of the people in here tonight? You know, we got a lot of awards to give. So here, I have the honor and privilege of giving you all the protocol tonight. I have an assistant, Dr. Robinson. I have an assistant who will be on the stage with me in a second. Because we're going to call you up for your award. And when you're called, we're going to do Lifetime Achievement Awards, which is incredible. Not everybody can earn a Lifetime Achievement Award. And then we have some icon awards, and then we have a few other awards that will be given out this evening. Yes, yes? So if your name is called for the Lifetime Achievement Award, and we have some special awards too that I'm holding up here that's just incredible. I gotta keep it close. So if you hear your name called, I'm gonna step back. We're gonna give you your award. And then we're going to ask you just to take a moment to tell us a little bit about yourself. Just a moment. Because we got quite a few up there in the air, but we really want to recognize you and acknowledge your service to our community. So our first Lifetime Achievement Award, isn't it beautiful? Can we see? Yes, yes. It's so beautiful. Our first Lifetime Achievement Award goes to none other than the Dr. Nathan Mitchell. Be careful on those steps coming up.
Hello, everyone. I'm just very excited to be here. Just the opportunity to be selected to receive this award. Many accomplishments. I'm one that had to start from the ground up and just dig my way. You know, I started out as an indie artist in the music industry, and my journal has led me to earn 3 NAACP Image Award nominations, 1 Grammy nomination. And all of that happened by myself. But now, you know, it's like now a lot of my work is put towards trying to merge music to mental wellness to help people, you know, become a better them when it comes down to just being a human being. So I'm just very appreciative. You know, Dr. Carl, thank y'all so much. Thank y'all so much for this opportunity just to come and just be able to be present among so many great dignitaries and amazing creatives and talents in this room. And I'm looking forward to future fellowships, future ventures to change the world together. Thank y'all so much. I appreciate it.
Mental wellness is something, you all. Okay? Mental well-being, mental wellness. It is also very, very comfortable right now. So if you're in that field, you definitely want to move forward in it. Our next Lifetime Achievement Award goes to none other than a St. Louis native, the Dr. Candace Carr. For talking about mental health, I am a licensed social worker and I specialize in intergenerational environment. I am very passionate about mental wellness. I say that mental wellness is dope, which means it's done on purpose every day. We have to understand that if we're not mentally well, we're mentally ill. It's a factor. And so I don't want us to be ashamed of it. So I created a mindset called chaos. And chaos is K-H-A-O-S. It stands for keep clean and overcoming struggles to urbanize mental health and mental wellness. So that it's just as simple as we looking good in here. And it's I went and got my makeup done. I went and got me something nice to wear. I went and saw my therapist to make sure that I got my mind right. So I pray and ask God all the time to allow me to travel the world to share the chaos mindset with all who are willing to learn it. And God has allowed me to go to Brazil, go to Africa, and go to different places, and I am so grateful for that, and I look forward to continuing to do that, and hopefully to heal and grow with some of you all in this room as well. Thank you so much. Congratulations, Dr. Cobb. You all, we need some more energy in here. Excited. Our next Lifetime Achievement Award recipient goes to the beautiful, extraordinary Dr. Robin Shepherd. As she comes,
structure. I've been flown all over on the implementation, mobilization team, setting up bridges, airports, highways, roads, bridges, and construction. Being the only person that looks like me across the world. I remember sitting in Doha, Qatar, you know, when they didn't want me there. But I was there and I was doing my thing. And it was really kind of boring when I was there and I was thinking, God, is this all you have for me? And then coming back to St. Louis and getting the opportunity to be director of community affairs at a radio station where I could reach the people that needed me, and then get the opportunity to be a columnist at the St. Louis, woo! Y'all know about the newspaper in St. Louis, that's the second largest publication in the nation. Come on now, come on, y'all get with me. Come on, y'all get with me. Y'all heard about Annie Malone, stuff like that. Well, I was the person walking around saying, get with this newspaper, where we were able to give out millions of dollars in scholarships. So that was me. But then came along somebody called Bishop Michael Bates. And he said, you need to be on our team. And I said, I guess I do. And here I am. And I've been in this game, y'all. They call my little situation sexy after 60. So think about how long I've been in the game. I've been in the game a long time. Okay, well, thank you for that. Thank you for that. But with all jokes aside, if you can reach somebody, teach somebody, please. The community needs us. This is where we've been, and it's an awesome feeling to be able to say, I helped somebody today. Yeah. I helped somebody today. I fed somebody today. So I'm going to stop because I think I can feel Stacy saying, dog. And I remember the dog show, and I don't feel like no hooks coming across my neck. But truly, guys, I've been with the Matthew Dickey's Boys and Girls Club. In fact, thank you, thank you. One person knows what that means. Way back in the day, it was just for little boys. And the founder said, I don't know what you got, lady, but you got some juice. So I'd like for you to head up the first committee of 100 women. And from that time to this, it is now the Matthew D. Boys and Girls Club. And thank y'all. It's all right. It's a beautiful thing to see those little girls down there now. I've been a part of that. And of course, radio. So I've been running around here doing that. But I want to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. My mom's been gone. Okay. Woohoo. Went to you. Stop. Mama's been gone for 35 years. Believe in angels? Yeah. So if you feel some whiz past you tonight, that's Mama. Because she can see this, okay? Yeah. Come on, somebody in the house. Now. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Come on, y'all, get out here to the stage.
pause the music for me. First of all, give an honor to God, who's the head of my life, and a special thank you to Dr. Carl Robertson and Bishop Dr. Michael Bates. I am so honored. I am, first of all, so used to, I was telling the gentleman during the interview, I'm so used to giving out awards and giving out accolades. So for me to receive something, it was just, it's an honor, but it threw me because I'm just not used to it. Even when I was told, I was like, well, how can I do this for others? You know, so I would like to tell you a little bit about myself. I have been in the business of entertainment for over 25 years. I'm a television and film producer. I have my own production company called The Butler Group. And then I have a summer program that we do every summer. It started in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and we moved it to St. Louis, Missouri, called Film Camp USA, where we help young people become, actually, they make their own movies, but we teach them how to control their own narratives instead of other people telling your story. Also, I'm the founder of the Gospel Music Hall of Fame of Missouri. I'm very proud of that. I have been in the gospel industry, again, for over 25 plus years with the Gospel Music Workshop of America, the Gospel Choirs and Choruses Convention. Big ups to our own Dr. Mary Beth Gentry out of St. Louis, Missouri, who's the president of the Choirs and Chorus Convention. I could stand here all night long and just tell you story after story after story, but I just want you all to know that I'm thankful, I'm grateful, and I'm appreciative, and I work hard. So I didn't come here to sit back. I came here to work and connect with others so that we can make this bigger and greater forever.
Hall of Fame, Missouri Hall of Fame, Gospel Museum, make sure that you connect with Dr. Monica Butler so you can find out how you can get your name on one of them groups there and go down in history with her. All right. Super excited for our next Lifetime Achievement Award recipient, none other than the Dr. Melody Cherie. Preservation. And today I've created over 800 entrepreneurs since 2020. 800 entrepreneurs all across the nation. And that is, you know, amazing and something I'm super proud of because that's what it's all about. When you get certain levels of knowledge, spreading that and sharing that and helping others build generational wealth and helping others find other streams of income that allow them to live the kind of life they want to live so they can be the blessing that they want to be. And that's truly what it's all about. So I'm so thankful for this award. Thank you all so much.
And I guess I'll see y'all up tomorrow, too.
Congratulations. Okay, our next Lifetime Achievement Award recipient with great recognition, AmeriCorps, and the offices of President of the United States Honors. This is strictly coming out of President Joseph R. Biden Jr. Award 2023. I just wanted to let you all know really what was on these people up here. This next award goes to none other than the Dr. Lucky Church.
My name is Lucky Church, by the way. I'm going to give air quotes on publicists. And the reason I do the air quotes is because I don't really believe in publicity in the traditional sense. Most of my clients will tell you, when they work with me, I'm more of a consultant. Because most people think they need PR, but they don't know what PR really is. Or they don't have a brand to really build something. So I come in, I work with companies like Nike, Jordan Brand, DJ Khaled, Fat Joe, the Grammys, HSBC. And I've been blessed to really live a good life through my career and through the beautiful people I meet. But thank you again to my home people, Lord, for believing in me always, my brothers, the twins, and my beautiful wife. I have to give her the biggest shout out right now because, and also Dr. Robinson, love you, brother.
Love you too, man.
But my wife, we just made 27 years this year. I tell this story, you know, I dressed even the way I did today, because it represents something to me. Sneakers on the bottom, because that reminds me of where I came from, how I started in this game. They're luxury sneakers, but they're still sneakers. And my wife was with me in the trenches when I couldn't figure out what I was doing, what I was going to be. When she used to slide me money under the table and say, hey, baby, pay the bill, because you need to look like the boss in the situation. And she patiently waited for me to become the man that I am today, and I love you for everything. Wow.
Thank you for making me cry.
Let's go.
Boys, Kings, and Queens. Hey, y'all. Hey. So I just want to say thank you to the university. Thank you for Dr. Robson. Thank you to my girl, Pilar. So I want to say, you know, I am not self-made. I have a team. And my team is my care guys, the people who have brought me resources, the people who have talked to me late at night when things were overwhelming. Those are the people that matter, the people that's with you shooting in the gym, right?
Right.
Yes.
Okay. So what I do is I have the first Black-owned television show in the state of Rhode Island, woman-owned, and I also have a nonprofit organization, and what I do is I collaborate with other nonprofit organizations to help expand, to make things bigger and better to help the community. So what I do is I love to do anything with involving domestic violence, anything to do with mental health in the Black and Brown communities. And that's what I love to do. I love to uplift and I love to help. So my television show, I love to uplift the underdog, right? Because there's a lot of us that doesn't get the help that we deserve. And that's something that I love to do. I know that that's my purpose here. So yeah, that's it.
A Lifetime Achievement Award recipient is Dr. Anton Quarles.
We all clap for each other, like there's a lot of blessings. So I'm gonna keep it short and sweet. Of course, you know, I feel like we all are, you know, humbled by this experience. You know, of course, giving honor to God, who's, you know, head of my life and all of ours. Would like to thank Dr. Robinson, HCU, of course, Ms. Dr. Pilar Scratch, which is a very close friend of mine for many years, and all of the fellow honorees. I feel like this, you know, we don't really get to see this a lot, a room of Black excellence, everybody celebrating each other, not, you know, tugging at, you know, who did it better or, you know, who's beneath who. But I'm most appreciative of this honor. My brother and I have been in the entertainment industry for years, although we look young. We started out 13 years old, singing background vocals for A-list R&B and gospel artists. We've, you know, crossed different genres of print modeling, TV, film. Here recently, we are a celebrity entertainment journalist. We've had the pleasure to interview the likes of Oprah Winfrey, Tyler Perry. The list goes on, but this honor is definitely something that was unexpected. But appreciate it. So I do thank all those who have a hand in it. And thank you.
That's good, that's good. Moving on with our next Lifetime Achievement Award goes to the Dr. Terrence Stewart. You are all together.
Amen.
Amen.
First and foremost, I want to say thank you to God, to the university. But I do want to tell y'all, this is the ratchet part of the event. I go by the name of Bebe, a.k.a. Mr. A-Bebe, from Shreveport, Louisiana. Shout out to St. Louis. You gotta know how to work the room, Doctor. Dr. Robinson and everybody who had a hand, my brother Radio, been in the game for a long time. I think about 27 years, and we've participated in making a lot of millionaires. But it feels good to get an award, but it feels even better when people feel like you deserve it. Right? So when I learned that I was getting this award, I felt honored. And you know, coming from a small town, Shreveport, 188,000 people, to be able to be recognized worldwide, you know, you take it for granted, like, ain't nobody gonna see me. But I always kept my head down, working, never looking to receive awards, just helping people, making a stallion. Master P, Rod Wave, NBA Youngboy, Jay-Z, Beyonce, Destiny's Child, in the gospel realm too. Y'all remember that song? It's the God in me. Hey, it's the God in me. Mary Mary, right there on K104. I understand the anointing, God-fearing, raised up in the church. I'm backsliding right now. But I'm going to turn it around. Believe me, I'm spiritual. I just know God, and I know God has something. Yeah, there you go. Let the block say amen. Let the block say amen again. Again, y'all, I do want to say thank you to the university. I'm looking forward to connecting the dots with you guys. Amen. I know what it is, black excellence at its finest. And I said, I'm going to go all the way to the White House with these platinum teeth. Let the black say amen.
Because my mission, there's two with Slutty Vegan, alongside Pinky, is to make sure that people continue to reimagine. Yes, I am vegan. I may not look like it, whatever looking like vegan means, often. But rest assured, whatever you eat that is your personal choice, you're friends with me. okay? This just won't be on my plate, okay? And the other mission is to make sure that I eliminate the stigma around mental wellness. So I, too, want to connect with every person in this room because I'm great at building relationships, which is why I've managed to help another black woman build a multi-million dollar business. So I am now on my mission to build a multi-million dollar foundation. So for every person in this room, pull out your cell phone. I'm gonna do something very unorthodox if you give me a moment. So I would love to give you my personal phone number because I'm very serious about making sure that I connect with every person in this room. That means a lot to me. And I tend to do that often. And for those that have met me in person, you have my personal, no, you actually got my work number. I gotta give you personal, but I just thought about that. Personal number. I'm very serious when I mean that. So, I am based out of Atlanta, Georgia. So we're gonna start with area code 470-865-2090. We're gonna spin the block. Area code 470-865-2090.
And for the people in the room, could you please state your name one more time?
Angel, A-N-G-E-L, Barnwell. B-A-R-N-W-E-L-L. All I ask is that you put how I met you, obviously which is going to be this dinner, and graduation tomorrow, your first and last name, and an email address. Because I live in my emails. Yes. Outside the fact that I went to the Beyonce concert.
Yes.
and I'm working on about 4 or 5 hours of sleep. So I'm very serious when I say it. Because if there's money in this room, I want it. If there's a connection in this room, I want it. Whatever money I have, I will give it. Whatever connections I have, I will give it. That is the only way that we as a community are going to connect and grow and allow for us to heal each other, make money with each other, and for opportunities like this, which I'm honestly still shocked about. I got this phone call in the middle of a 10 o'clock meeting.
Absolutely.
And I texted him and I was like, hey, can't talk right now. Can you text me? Congratulations, Dr. Barnwell. What?
Yeah.
I was shocked. So I am very grateful that this astounding university has decided to provide me with just a little bit of love. Because like too, I'm in the background. Not too many people know about me. Unless you dig in the history of Clay Vegan, then you know that there's 8 people. I am one of the 8 and there's 3 remaining. So I'm right beside Pinky. Look on the page. You will see I'm right beside her, catching the scissors, moving away with the proclamations. I'm out of the way because I know that I have a mission. So I want to be able to genuinely connect with everybody and whatever missions that you're on. If I can give help, I am only one woman, but I know for a fact that I come with a lot of force. I'm grateful for every last person in this room. Thank you for recognizing my hard work and my efforts, and I hope that every last one of us will be able to seriously put some spank on it. So thank you, and you have a great night.
Appreciate this, and I want to make sure I salute the organization everything that y'all been doing for the community and opening doors for a lot of people and building a network that a lot of people would never probably even meet each other in any time or circumstance. So I thank you for being here. I appreciate being here. And I also want to give a major shout out to my team.
Yes.
You wouldn't be nowhere without a team. And it's really what they say. Teamwork makes the dream work. And my team is everything to me, man. So I appreciate y'all. Thank y'all for everything that y'all do. And like I said, if y'all ever want to find me, you can always check us out. We own a company called Never Satisfied. It's a music and film production company. And, you know, talk to any one of the guys with the cameras, man. This is my team. They're out here helping. And salute to everybody else that was a part of this and making this happen. So thank you very much.
Yes. All right, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for none other than the Dr. Larry Sanders.
Senior, so this award is for both of us, and it's amazing that you know, landing on this day. A little bit about me: I retired from the NBA in 2016. I played for the Milwaukee Bucks. I retired for my mental wellness. I had a $44 million contract. That was in the first year of it. And I let it go because I know I had to focus on my mental health. I had to focus on my family. And I saw so many people, so many guys who made $100 million and, you know, within 5 to 10 years of retirement, dealt with so many issues and were broke, you know, broken homes, broken relationships. So I knew that that wasn't a recipe. It wasn't just to put your head down and grind it out. You actually had to address those issues. So I did, and it was the best decision I ever made. You know, I started an artist incubator right away. Out of LA, I was housing homeless artists, helping them with stability, trying to give back to what helped me get to my situation, but also provide knowledge and guidance, because that's what I didn't have. Now I'm head first into the mental health space. I'm an advocate. I like to speak out. I like you know, to do engagements, and I'm working to build a facility right now. So I love it. Everyone is, you know, expanding on that. The conversation is alive and well. It's a beautiful thing. So I'm here to connect as well. So I would love to connect with all of you and build. And just thank you. I'm honored to be here.
Can you guys come?
Baby, in my old days, I would say I'm gangster graceful. But since I'm changed now, I'm a saved sinner. I'm gracefully grateful for all that God does for me. Because you don't know my story. A lot of times people come up and they say, people see your glory, but they don't know your story. Man. So when they see me pull up sometimes, like, oh, no, baby, God, I had a private, had a whole bunch of private pains, which caused me to be publicly blessed. So you'll have to read my book to know the story. I'm not, I don't have enough time to tell it. But the name of the book is Grace and Favor from Prison to Paid. Because I was wrongfully convicted by the federal government in 2011. I know I don't look like it. I won the appeal at the end of the prison sentence because someone committed a fraud against my business. Y'all ought to be clapping. One day I asked God, what was my purpose for sitting here wasting time, because I'm big on time. And I don't waste time wasting time. We only get one shot at this life. So I need to maximize it while I have the time. So anyway, it brought about Keeping Families Connected. Google Keeping Families Connected, follow me on social media. I sat there all the time. My son had just gotten killed. He was my only son, 17 years old, in Louisiana. I'm from Louisiana, Shreveport in the house, baby. So anyway, he get killed, I moved to Texas, get wrongfully convicted, nobody bring my daughters to see me. So I was like, okay, God, why do you let me waste all this time wasting time? I could have been creating businesses. You know, I know how to make money. I flip money. That's what I do legally now. Hey. But I didn't get to see my daughters. Nobody brought them to see me. My mom and my dad were deceased. Their grandparents died after Katrina. Nobody brought them. So from that birth, Keeping Families Connected, now I provide luxury prison trips in black SUVs and Mercedes. For kids that are separated from their parents. And I'm not government funded, baby, I'm God-blessed. So I can stand up here and say, to God be all the glory. Yeah. I want to thank Dr. Jacobs for referring me for this honorary doctor's degree. I want to thank God, first and foremost. And I want to thank my king, because without that 10% allowance, I couldn't provide them prison trips. Anyway, y'all be good.
HBCU out of Jackson, Tennessee, Lane College. I'm just among, so hippopotamus happy to be among, as mentioned earlier, to be among African Americans that are doing powerful things within our community. And just to be blessed to receive this honor, just a little bit about me. I'm a wife, I'm a mother, I'm a first lady, I'm a best-selling author. I am an entrepreneur of a barbecue restaurant. We just closed on a store today. To God be the glory of the store, my husband and I. And numerous of things that God is doing in our life. But just know that those who are in the room, God has planted the anointing. So just know attacks are going to come. But I am truly excited to be connected. I'm going to be like Dr. Barnwell's. If you want my contact, I would love to build a relationship. I'm not about take, and just pulling from your context. Well, what can I do to pour into you and to pour into your blessing? God bless you, and thank you so much.
good. All right, our next Lifetime Achievement Award goes to Dr. Anita Hawkins. The five-year-old girl who was raped and molested since she was 12 years old. I am the 13-year-old who had her first pregnancy and was forced to have an abortion with no sedative. I am the 15-year-old who became a teen mom and was told she was going to do nothing with her life and signed over to the state as a legal minor, living homeless from pillow to post, and set out in the pursuit of proving everyone wrong. Amen. So today I stand before you as a builder. I launched my construction company in 2006. I am a franchise owner. I am a producer. Right now, just close up with that, praise God, working on an animation and a feature film. I'm a model in the face of several brands. I went from being the one who didn't have and the one who needed everything from everybody else to being the one that everyone needs to call today. So I tell you to not allow the words of anyone else to be your destination, because it's not. Always lead with what God has given you, whatever path that is. With my nonprofit, Find One Reason to Smile, I wake up every day smiling. My girl, Leticia, she knows I wake up literally at 5 o'clock every morning smiling, singing, music. Since y'all ever saw y'all play, I've been at that table singing. Because I have so much to be thankful for. My life and the trajectory could have been totally different. But it was because of what was put inside of me to not allow that to hinder what I knew what God had for me. So I'm thankful to have been in a position right now today through Find One Reason to Smile to touch the lives, feed, house, bring water to women in areas of Zimbabwe. I have housed and fed over 400,000 women right now today. I started drilling water wells in Zimbabwe in 2014. I have since then literally brought water to over 1 million women in Zimbabwe. So I am thankful. When I say I can't explain the appreciation of being honored. Oh, and by the way, this is my fourth Lifetime Achievement Award. Amen. And well earned it is. We're going to shift up just a little bit for our Alumni of the Year Award. Harvard Christian University Alumni of the Year Award. Beautiful, yes. The Icon Award. Let me read a little bit about it. This award honors alumni who have significant contributions to the growth and development of Harvard Christian University. These individuals have demonstrated outstanding achievement in their professional careers and have impacted the university's growth and development. This award, we have the esteemed privilege of giving to Dr. Pillar Rich.
My love and my wife. I have probably the roughest year of my life this year. This summer, I nearly lost my life. I was hospitalized for the majority of the summer due to an infection and a global surgery. But I survived, and I am here. I wanted to dedicate this to, if you follow me on Instagram, you know my son and I have like such a close bond, and he's like everything to me. He's not here, but I wanted to dedicate the honor to him because he actually saved my life. He rushed me to the hospital, so because of him, you know, I'm here, and they found out I had 11 pulmonary embolisms, so if I didn't have him, I wouldn't be here on the radio today. And also, Dr. Robinson, thank you. Love you guys so much. One of my closest friends, Remy, Antoine, Andre, Lucky, B, B, T. I feel like the lineman right now. Andre, I love you all so much. Thank you for being here for me. And just, thank you. Appreciate you guys.
All right, so we got another Icon Award. Okay, it is my honor to introduce this year's Icon Award recipient, whose influence transcends sectors and resonates on a global scale. Inspired by a biblical passage, Revelations 11:15-18, Michael Bates Sr., also known as the Business Bishop, a multifaceted American trailblazer, he is a successful businessman, wealth influencer, political strategist, author, radio personality, and as chairman and CEO of SPN Media Plus, he utilizes cutting-edge technology and strategic marketing to reach over 180 million users monthly, offering content that spans inspirational training, sports, finance, lifestyle, and more. Y'all clap right there. That's good, right? But there are more. Furthermore, he is the co-founder and CEO of Smart People Network Incorporated, a membership organization of Kingdom Entrepreneurs, boasting a robust community of over 20,000 members. Serving as the Executive Vice President of Harvard Christian University, Michael Bates Sr. is also a dedicated father, global pastor, and a mentor, and other spiritual and business leaders. From nurturing musical prodigies to negotiating deals in the hundreds of millions, from local corner stores, we say we're going ghetto, from the local corner store, and all the way to the international landmark, the Taj Mahal. The Business Bishop has touched the hearts and souls of millions and revolutionized the trajectory of tens of thousands of businesses. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce to you, to some, and present to others, none other, and I find your name on this one, the Business Bishop, HD, Dr. Michael Bates Sr.
You sneak it in on me, you've done a good job.
Right.
I will say why, but My mama used to teach me that wild means having wonderful order within. And my stuff's simple, that's simple. I know what it feels like to want to do something and have no help. I know what it feels like for the person sitting next to you to know the secret sauce to it and won't tell you. And I made God a promise.
All right.
That if he'd ever give me an inch of power, if he'd ever give me a piece of platform, I'd share with everybody who would be willing to listen.
Yeah.
To Dr. Carl Robinson, my big brother, Jonathan, and then old lady at home, my mama. When I left the other day on the road before we could get here, she called me and she was just crying. She's 87. And I said, "Mama, why are you crying?" And she said, "Boy, I'm so proud of my firstborn." I said, "Mama, I ain't done too much of nothing to be proud of." She said, "Be quiet." And she said, "Out of 87 years, if I have not shown you how much I love you." I said, "Mama, you have." She said, "But it wasn't until you got on a plane the other day that it hit me that I need to just express to you how much I love you." And I say that to say, anybody know me, I probably got the biggest mouth in this room. But I'm literally speechless tonight. I'm like you, Monica. I'm used to giving. And icon, I can't even spell that. Thank God. Thank you. And if I could ask you to do anything, together, let's jump. Let's do something in this room that has never been done. Let's show the enemy that the crab mentality is over with. Let's show one another that there's enough for all of us. I still believe this, man. What you make happen for others, God make happen for you.
Come on.
I'm going to sit down. Do me a favor. Grab somebody by the hand. Say this real loud, seriously. When I look at you, I see God. And when you look at me, you see God.
You see God.
The way we feel about each other,
the way we feel about God.
How can you love God
whom
you've never seen and not love
your
brother and sister? Watch this. And I love you. And there ain't nothing you can do about it.
We have one more Icon Award called the Sage Award in recognition of the most gifted thought leader of our times, called to speak to an ever-changing world. This award will be presented to the Bishop T.D. Jakes Sr. and accepted by
Dr. Candace
Flores.
Well, clearly, as you know, I'm not Bishop Jakes, although I was in the airport once and a lady
walked up to me and said, "Brother Jakes." I said, "No, he was a little taller." Just a little, not much. I am honored tonight to accept this award on behalf of Bishop T.D. Jakes, who has been such a powerful influence, not only in my life, but in the body of Christ as a whole. Our relationship started back in 19, came to Dallas in 96. Our relationship started in 97. So it started as a business relationship, and then I became a part of his family. So we have a long relationship. So as you know, Bishop Jakes is doing some powerful things on the behalf of Bishop Jakes, the Potter's House, T.D. Jakes Foundations, and a plethora of other businesses and foundations. Thank you, Dr. Robertson. Thank you, Harvest Christian University. God bless you.
We're going to take a 2-minute intermission in case someone needs to go to the restroom. Or you want to move around a little bit? Or shall we keep going? Let's show up. We keep going,
Thank you.
some people over on the photo spot. If you would usher them on over. Can we get some support on bringing the photo over so we can go ahead and prepare to wrap up with the final announcement? There is a change in venue in the morning, so you don't want to miss this next announcement.
We have just a couple more honors to do, and then we'll be able to move on. All right, y'all ready?
Yeah.
All righty. Just waiting for everybody to return to their tables.
Okay.
All righty. We have just a couple more honors. We're going to go ahead and we're going to switch up the segment just a little bit. Harvard Christian University has a chaplaincy program, and in the chaplaincy program, we are looking to merge community relief in terms of being able to provide assistance, as well as being able to look at what is now considered the cutting edge ministry. So, I would like to start with presenting the first chaplaincy recognition. Alrighty, and the first recognition goes to none other than Dr. Sammy Akimalero. And this is his badge here. And it says this, by the authority of the Board of Chaplaincy Commission and Licensing, we recognize upon Dr. Sammy Akimalero this chaplaincy license and commission, together with all honors, rights, and privileges belonging to this license and commission, in witness thereof before God and men, this license and commission is granted, given in Dallas, Texas, on the 22nd day of September 2023.
Let me first of all say thank you, Dr. Carl Robinson, and thank you to the university. I think the road to success is always under construction. And I think whatever it takes is what we all have to unite and help one another. Sky is the limit.
Yes.
And we are not there yet. But from today's henceforth, we'll continue to do the right thing.
Yes.
And let God continue to bless us and empower us to do good. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. And the next chaplain's recognition goes to Dr. Sherry Dahl Richardson. And it says, by the authority of the Board of Chaplaincy Commission and Licensing, we recognize and confer upon Dr. Sherry Dahl Richardson this, together with all honors, rights, and privileges belonging to this license and commission, and witness thereof before God and men. The license and commission is granted, given in Dallas, Texas, on this 22nd day of September 2023.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and the Holy Spirit. So we are here to love. God is love.
Yes.
And so that's our mission of being a chaplain. So we are the first emergency respondents. First of all, you have to love people and love what you do. So if you love people, love yourself, and love what you do, it comes really simple. So we decided, matter of fact, Dr. Sammy A. Malero is one of my patients. So I did his therapy, and I do a whole lot of things, you know, working with the Don King production and all the boxers, which is my favorite sport. I own Ashbridge and A Celebrity Spa in Duncanville, been there over 30 years, have a salon in Fort Worth, Dolls House of Beauty number one, number two, do hair and makeup for TV and film, physical therapy, so the list just go on and on. So basically what you do is once you reach one goal, then you say, okay, what's next?
Yeah.
So I've been around for over 40 years. I work with the great Al Wash Entertainment, ALW, in Dallas, Texas.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, let me just say this. Everybody needs to make sure that they go to the preview and Gremlin game on next weekend. He's been doing that game for over 45 years. So I've been around for a brief minute. Don't look like it, but you know how it is. Black don't crack. All the beautiful ladies up in here tonight, they know how that is. So thank you very much. Thank you for this.
Yes, and the final chaplaincy recognition goes to Dr. Areli Roxanne Miyasu Allegra. Congratulations. And it says the Board of Commission and Licensing by the authority of the Board of Chaplaincy Commission and Licensing recognized and conferred the Chaplaincy and License Commission, together with our honors, rights, and privileges belonging to this license and commission, in witness thereof before God and men. This license and commission is granted, given in Dallas, Texas, on the 22nd day of September 2021.
I'd like to thank you, Dr. Carl Robinson, and also thank Harvard University, Christian University, and also thank everybody for being here tonight, and say congratulations to each one of you. As African descendants, what I believe that will change our narrative is to unite. Together we can make the change, and I believe that being here, if we stay connected, we can make it happen. So good night. Thank you.
All righty. I think these next honors are something that you don't want to miss. So I would like to start with this next President's Lifetime Achievement Award recipient goes to none other than Dr. Gerald Liddell.
Each and every one of you all tonight. If you don't mind, just put your hands together for yourself right now. Thank God for that. Hallelujah. As you all had a chance to hear about, if you want to know a little bit about me, I'm a servant. My main purpose on earth is to serve. And you all had a chance to listening to the Bishop, Honorable Bishop Michael Bay Sr. And the fact that what his achievements are. I thank God for Dr. Robinson and Dr. Lane and the university for this. But there are some things about Bishop that he don't really talk about. That's in the beginning, I've been serving for about 40 years or so. In the beginning of the ministry, we actually had a member commit suicide. And I had the privilege, I was going to the church to do some work. And Bishop said, let's go to the hospital. Young lady, she committed suicide, took an overdose. And I went with him. And we prayed, the family asked for prayer. And he and I working together, one could chase 1,000. Two could put 10,000 to flight. She came back to life. You don't hear too much of that. So I knew right then, I'm going to have to stay close to this man of God. Because he truly can hear from God. Not saying others don't, but you know, with this organization coming together, with Dr. Robinson, D. Bishop Bass, and Stacy, them together, you know, when bishops say God said, you better listen. You know, I will guarantee you that if you stick with him, you know, there's nothing you won't achieve. You can't go, the sky's the limit. I guarantee you the sky's the limit. I've never tried to overtake his position. I never tried to outshine more. My whole heart is just to serve. What can I do to serve? And the Bible happens to say the greatest in the kingdom is he that serves. A lot of people don't want to serve. A lot of people want recognition. But it ain't about that. You know, everyone up in here, great people up in here, but your purpose is to serve. And in the meantime, with that, God has blessed me to work with troubled youth. Youth who would come up to somebody and just shoot them in the head and walk away. And those are the ones that he's allowed me to work with. Based on, as Bishop give the word, and I take that teaching into the classroom, talk to them, and I learned one thing about all of them. They got good hearts.
Yeah.
They just on the wrong track. So it's been an honor to serve them. It's been an honor to whoever God placed before me to serve. Because guess what? It ain't about us, but it's all about him.
Amen.
All right, to God be glory.
That was fantastic. I want to consider kind of a preliminary recognition, and I know we normally don't do this, but I believe in giving honor to people who have really stepped by this university, and this particular person has literally stepped in clutch. Even though we don't have their award physically here, but I just felt like honoring them anyway. And I want everyone to give a round of applause to Dr. Tavon Skinner. Sir, I don't think you heard me. Big brother, Dr. Tavon Skinner, an honorary recognition tonight.
was my time, man. It seems empty right now, and I'm only playing around. I want to thank HCU. Thank you, Dr. Robinson Jr. Thank you, Dr. Robinson Sr. Thank you to everybody in the room. Thank you. Black excellence at its fullest. Good night, everyone.
Contact with the Legacy Center if you want to honor someone who is no longer here. But I only thought it was right to do this recognition because this was something that had been in talks for quite some time, and I think if anyone was deserving of this kind of recognition, it's this person. And it goes to the late Dr. Ermias S. Ghetto, which belongs to Nipsey Hussle. Wow. This is the first posthumous honors of the President's Lifetime Achievement here. And unfortunately, because of the conflict of his family schedule, they could not be here tonight. So I'm receiving it on their behalf. To the late Nipsey Hussle, we miss you.
Yeah.
This is for you. All right. Oh, this is my favorite. I'm gonna love this one. Okay. So even though he could not be here tonight, I think he sends his best wishes and regards. And this President's Lifetime Achievement Award goes to someone who is considered a staple of hip-hop soul music. And we would like to give this to none other than Dr. Taleb Johnson, a.k.a. Music Soul Child. Jose receiving it on his behalf.
Because unfortunately he is unable to be here, but I'm going to have, and she's not going to get up, but I am going to pass her the microphone so Dr. Pilar Scratch can say something on his behalf.
Music Soul Child and Mocha are really good friends of mine, like family, for the past decade. So he couldn't be here tonight. Mocha's celebrating her birthday, Hannah, and he's with her. So he is going to post it and make a video for school, and he just said, this is an amazing honor, and you'll see it in the video. So he wants to say thank you.
All right, Jose, don't have a seat yet, sir. Don't have a seat yet. Because of your hard work in the university, we decided to make something honorary for you as well. During the last graduation, he literally stepped in a clutch in a lot of places, and he just filled in and said, how can I help? How can I be involved? Tell me what I need to do. Just use me. That's what I'm here for. And oftentimes, I love what Dr. Gerald Liddell said. It's about serving. And for us, we love to recognize people who serve. And so tonight, we're going to do him an honorary President's Lifetime Achievement Award medal, and we're going to pin him. Now, I'm going to tell you something about the pin. The pin actually belongs to the one who has committed to the most service. That's what the pin is for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the tradition of the way that it would be done, let's just say, if the president was here, okay? So, all right, so again, this is Lady Clark Hillary. Thank you. Y'all know the pen is right here. So I'm going to pin it like the president would, okay? And let's just say I've done this a few times, so I promise you he won't leave.
You'll see I'm wearing pink. If I bleed. Please understand, I'm a person who, I'm like most of you, I am a giver by nature. It's probably one of my downfalls, as my husband would call it. I give more than I receive is what I've been told by many. And I've always been that way, and I pride myself on it because I was born into a family where it was very, well, less fortunate. I grew up in the projects like a lot of people did. I'm Puerto Rican, Dominican, Black. Indian, so I'm a mutt. Even though I'm a light-skinned mutt, I'm still a mutt. But growing up in my hood, I had to work hard just like every single person in here, and I love the Black Excellence IT in this room, and I grew up in it, and I embrace what I had to work hard for, but I also love to embrace and embody and celebrate those around me who have also had that same journey. My niece is a perfect example of that, Dr. Pilar Scratch. If any of you could ever understand the journey that she has done from when she was a child till now, I told her she needs to write a book. Because her journey is profound. And she is not only a phenomenal mother to a 12-year-old child prodigy, she is a phenomenal friend, a phenomenal woman, and an absolute amazing person to surround yourself with. So she is my rock when it comes to my success, and I love her for it. And I love Lucky and the twins and everybody else. And I want to thank, of course, Dr. Robinson and Dr. Robinson Sr. for this honor. I appreciate it, and I love you guys for it. Thank you so much.
Tonight has been
absolutely incredible.
Let's give ourselves a round of applause, everybody! And then to the last man standing. Now, some of you all will be graduating tomorrow. Yes, yes?
Yes.
All right. We have a change in venue for tomorrow. So we need, and it's right down the street. It's not far from here, but we need to get you the address. So if you're following Harvard's Christian University, it's going to be posted on our IG. If you're not on IG, as the Bishop Dr. Michael Bates said, what if you're not on IG? Then you're going to text Jonathan, Dr. Jonathan Robinson. Give me a number, please.
Okay. Number is 469-693-2711.
And say it again for the people in the back.
A little louder in the back. 469-693-2711.
Now, there are some people who have already left, and they didn't get the announcement. So if you know any of them, we're going to send a text out, but we don't want to leave anybody behind. So anybody that you know is graduating and in your graduating class, please share, tag, and make aware. Yes, yes?
Yes.
We're going to close out. We just want to thank you so much. Before we close, the bishop is here, so we're going to ask him to close us out in prayer, traveling mercies as we go forth. And make sure that you get the new venue location, because we will not be in this room. So we want to make sure that you're in the right place at the right time. Fair enough?
Fair enough.
All right, Bishop, the mic is yours, please.
Give Dr. Stacy Lane a wonderful hand. Bring God. All right, let's stand. Mr. President, are you fine? Anything else you need, sir? Give our president a hand, please. Yes. He's a hard one. Thank you.
gracious and eternal God. Nobody like you. Nobody can do like you do. For every man, woman, boy, or girl in this place, we collectively just tell you thank you. You've been better to us than we have been to ourselves. God, tonight we don't know what the future holds, but we know you hold the future. So every man, woman, boy, or girl in this place, we ask that you continue to bless and take them to the next level of their life. For all that you do tonight, we promise you, man, we promise you, not to try to take any of the praise or any of the glory. We will tell it from the highest mountain that every good thing that happens, you did it. This is our prayer tonight. Make us servants to one another. In Jesus' name, continue to shine on the vision of Harvest Christian University. God, we thank you for the people right now who, well, sometime during this week, open up their pocketbooks to help continue the vision. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Help somebody. Help somebody.
Make another announcement. If people looking for media, we have a media link on that.
Hey, attention, y'all. How y'all doing? Everybody looks good. Everybody looks good. We took some beautiful pictures of y'all. If y'all would like to see them, we have a link in the back that I would like y'all to scan, and y'all be able to find all the media, the interviews, and the live stream. Okay? So if y'all meet me in the back, you can get a scan, and I can, we can get it sent to your phone. Okay?
Okay, well, so I see you.